I was so cautious about the snipers. As I was moving on my gun, I was so steady. I could keep looking around, watching the snipers. These snipers are not stationed in one place. They are ever just scattered in the whole country. After my training, I'd never went for any battle. This is my first time. I wasn't scared. If it's your time, it does not matter whether you're in Uganda, whether you're in Mogadishu, anywhere. It can happen to you.
Is it trauma?
That man was a civilian and is working with the construction company around here.
From this is the entrance, I think. Yes, it's the
entrance. For him, they don't put on helmets, and he got shot on the head. And the bullet got stuck in the head, in the brain. So when he was brought here, we really tried our level best to help him, but unfortunately, he did not survive. He died that day in the night.
Al-Shabab sometimes use civilians as a shield. We try as much as possible to limit civilian casualties. You cannot really say you will not harm civilians, but the most important thing now is the army now to take responsibility of the casualties.
Why are you here?
He lied.
Why are you here?
I want to go to Somalia because those people are insecure. I want to go for peacekeeping. I want to gather a peacekeeper. Seeing me with a gun doesn't necessarily mean that I'm going to kill someone I come across. It is for self-defense, for my protection and also for their protection. I became a gunner because when I was for my basic here in single training school, I mugged one of the best shooters.
Kenya! John, what's wrong with you? John, what happened? John, can you talk to me? Hey, John! Hey, John!
Oh, I grew up in the war zone area. So I saw how people were suffering during the insurgency in northern Uganda for about 24 years. So I've been one of the victims.
Oh, was shot here.
sorry, you're gonna be fine, eh? Okay, John? John, can you talk to me?
I thought it wise maybe I also come and join hand together with my colleagues and we serve the nation in military, another nation, because I don't want to see people suffering from due to insurgency, terrorism.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! Get in!
With the training that we're getting here, I know we're going to acquire the skill and we're going to use it there. With time, we shall get used to the situation.
If you are going too fast, maybe somebody from the other section is going to see you there. Boom, boom, because he will be afraid. Boom, boom. Mm. Yes. One of you, boom, on the floor. It was okay, it was okay. This kind of training must have a lot of drill, 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 drill. But for the first time, it was
good.
It was good.
Okay.
Continue like this. Good.
Basic training. It's a different thing. And it is also a kick. You have to tighten your bombs. When I joined, I didn't tell them. They came to learn about it as they were seeing I'm missing from them. I was not going to check on them. That's when they came to realize that I joined.
God bless you. Welcome back.
Hallelujah!
And God bless you.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Okuva omwaka ogwana nayira mu mwaka gwana n'etaano aye nga ndi kuliya era kiri muno era abantu abange baakubanga ati nafu aye nayira n'alama n'okutuusa mpigano ndiwo nkaaliwo era n'akuba nti amiina abakuumire wuwonawone wazira wate abakuumira ekintu ekiida tokitya iwe gumira nti wamaze kukola ki kwewaayo
Roselyn and I met on this very village. I fell in love with her in 2004. Unfortunately, in 2005, I lost my job. I have not discovered anything bad about her. Otherwise, given the nature of their job, you can fear somebody of a ranking officer can easily entice those women into those sexual acts.
If someone doesn't have true love, actually they go messing around. Because I know that's what scares most men. Staying away from the wife for some time, you will be scared that maybe you will meet the wife when she has messed up. Eh? But with me, my husband, trust he has in me. I could say maybe it is 100%.
I also don't feel so much good because I'm ever away. Even my children, they need parental care. We faced a financial crisis, so I had to go and look for work. All the work I was doing, I was just volunteering. I was not getting anything, so I decided to join UPDF, where I started getting salary.
Roselyn is going to Somalia, but as a human being, I feel some bit of worry. But given the nature of the job she joined, I have nothing to do about it. But I just pray to God to keep her alive.
Ladies and gentlemen, we just landed at Mogadishu International Airport. The outside temperature is 30 degrees centigrade.
When we came and we landed at the airport, I was so much scared. They told us from in the aircraft that when you get down, you just have to run. So As we were landing down, I was very much scared. I thought maybe the whole airfield was just full of Al-Shabaab or bombs landing around. Then when we landed down, I saw a lot of our colleagues, our soldiers. We were there at the airport, and they were just standing watching us. So from there, I became okay because I knew the place was safe.
Tunataka kutoa dressing hii, tuweke ingine. This gentleman was brought this morning. He got a bomb blast. She has multiple wounds. Every day we change the dressing and we keep on giving him injection as prescribed by the doctor, antibiotic and painkiller. We've seen that there's an injury to the spinal cord. It will be the doctor's decision to decide where we can manage him from here, or he may be referred to Nairobi.
Sasa wale Al-Shabaab walikuja kutupiga marisasi kama saa tatu na nusu. Tupiga maombi waya matatu, wakazipiga ndani ya kroti. Wakapiga na marisasi. Sasa hivi kwa haraka haraka, alafu wakaendelea, wakapiga. Kama nga minota 30.
This is my first deployment outside Uganda. Very proud to be here and serve our soldiers, the UPDF troops, and the Burundi soldiers. I feel happy about that, really.
Okay, my first convoy was not all that scary. I would think of the snipers. When you are moving in a convoy, the snipers are just there, up, just shooting at us. This war has stayed for so long. But I was surprised I found the buildings and some civilians still were alive. Those Al-Shababs, they are ever with the civilians. You cannot identify that this is the Al-Shabaab, this is a civilian.
Let up. Bona what? Bring, let up. Hi. But then you got a yogurt. You got here against the kuleta apples. Hey. Rijara Angolia, apples.
Some time back, AMI used to be for men only, but I praise Uganda because there is gender equality. Man can be a driver, and a woman also can be a driver. Man can be a Ghana, woman also can be a Ghana. Engineers, doctors, everything. In fact, what a man can be. Actually, a woman also can do.
Those living for Red Mosque.
As a soldier, you don't need to have that fear. When you are going for a front line, you need to forget all about the fear. Because they normally say there is no retreat and no surrender. So all that fear, you have to forget about it when you are going for a mission.
Okay, that one is a gunshot.
We are just 100 meters from Bakara Market. Bakara Market is an economic hub, and I think the enemy raises part of his capital to finance this war through Bakara Market. Our objective as of now, of course, is to make sure that we capture Bakara Market. We don't intend to enter Bakara to fight within the market, but we need to cut it off.
Vita hapa ni ya ghafla tu.
wanakula miraa zao, wanachanganyikiwa, wanasikia tu, wanaanza kumapigo tu. Hakuna vita kali sana ambayo inatisha sana. Hakuna muda, saa yote wanataka, hata sasa hivi tupo hapa wanasikia tu wanataka.
Ndio juzi wakati sina ingia hapa, mtu mmoja alikuwa anakaa hapa. Ndio kazi yake alikuwa analala hapa, kupiga piga sisi hapa. Paka sisi ni kajani sisi pokoja yeye kutoka hapa.
Naona kama Uganda officer kweli.
Hiyo vita hiyo. Hiyo watu wanakuja kujaribu sisi tu. Sisi hapana songa mbele. Vita kama wewe unapigana, wewe unapiga mimi yako na kutoka kwa nini? Kwa sekta hiyo. Sasa wewe unakuja jaribu yeye wewe unapiga piga yeye juu juu wewe unakimbia. Hiyo sio vita.
Mujuni.
Tuko kwa peacekeeping, sio kuja kupiganisha hawa.
Wewe kwa master Mujuni.
Chama cha AU. Tunafuatilia sheria. Ilikuwa sio sheria. Ah, tulikuwa tuliondoa watu tangu.
Wewe unapenda hii open shoes
na sasa. Niko na viatu tatu.
Yeye anasema viatu yangu misha.
Misha namna gani? Niko na viatu kwa nyumba nataka
kuvaa. Nataka kama risabu hata kama mpanda kwa hurumuth ameweka kwa sala kama hii piki. Hizi abani huwezi kusonga mbele.
Hawezi kan.
Yes. Ni hurumuth ni juu kabisa. Anaona kila sehemu.
Hizi tu. Hapana, hapana.
Unaribu unaribu communication ya inchi.
Hakuna faida.
Mchana kukutana.
The most important weapon in defeating the insurgents is winning the people. If you win the hearts and minds of the people, then you will win the war. This war here is different because in the region, the East African region, we have been fighting in the jungles. So here, this is a challenge because it is a built-up area where your enemy is always near you. This is our first experience in fighting in built-up areas, but we are coping.
Confirm when you're not poor.
At the moment, we are only two countries deployed to fight Al-Shabab here in Somalia. If other African countries could also contribute troops, I think we shall liberate Mogadishu and Somalia as a whole.
Drying and also scrubbing it.
This kid was brought in around 4 months ago with gunshot wounds in the pelvis areas around the waist. Mustafa was hit from here. This is the entrance of the bullet. It got out. That's why he has two wounds. So the whole of the pelvic bones, we are just destroyed. I just go straight. So we are moving the second bullet. You will find that most of them are not shot directly.
Mustafa, you'll be alright, eh?
Somali children don't mind about bullets. For them, they don't mind. They continue playing football and doing their other work they may wish. They don't mind about bullets. It's not like any other countries. The moment you hear a bullet, you hide yourself in the house. It is not the case here in Somalia. They continue their work.
I'm a doctor.
So now we're ready to
go.
Oh,
I'm a doctor.
I'm so cool.
So you leave the rest. You know, I think that Hanunka can tell me what Mataga Makada Karo Hanunka will see the machine and the water. I just told off to make a Javanta. Of what Makada Karo? I'm not joking. Half a day no sock and no home. I saw no. معنا عدد واسكوب مساكين أنا عفدين واكن نمت أنت رح أقول نمت إن العاوية راشينك وحنا ما هاي سنو مهر كرنو محاسة ما وح الله كان واي ما كقالي كري هبين إيه ما أنا وصاصة وكرؤيا وحنا ما كقالي كري
لكن أنا كوحاب النقص يدرم بدك قبل هذا شباب هاليك قاتين كسو عررين
anakiya wixii yaraa aan soo helno aan sadaqo ka sii bixinayna aa qofka naga sii tabaray caaw dabka loo shidaa u kaalmayna ibil muxuu haystaa camal qofkan waa kaliita camal anoo waxaan arkay subaxii aan quraacan saddex beri aan quraacan qadaynin lacag yaroon wato qof iga liita intaan arkay meel meeshaana ku arkay aan siiya nin qaawan oo ilmo yaryarna wato hooyadood waa dhimatay aad yihiin colaada ha halkaan noogu jiran shabaab habeenkii caadiyan qayladooda u maqlaynay intay dadka noogu dilaayeen waa cararayna isgooyska intanoo soo istaagana la cararay dadkay intuu ku dilaan ninkoo naagaa soo qaadi jirnay shacabka waxba galabsanin waddadan jidkan maraayaan bakaaro gelayaan nin halkaas liif ula saarnaa jira inta hadduu ku dhinta annakaa soo qaadi jirnay ciidankaa soo qaadi jiray war dhibaato badanaa meeshaan ka soo martay intaan yaroo hadda uganda iyo soomaaliya inta israaciil la fogeeyey aan nabad aragnaan ku iran nabad nooma oolin
nolosheeda aada aaday u liidata mawaa wax shaqo oo nolol maalmeedkayga iga wax rajaadaan gadaan waxaan aragnaa madaxda dad qof lasoo gooyo inta iridana loo soo dhiga taleefona loo soo dira dhaa haddii aadan hawshaad ku jirtiin jaadkay waxaa gadaysiin aadan ka bixina saasaa qoorta laydinkaga gooya
I think I'll be able to save some money. This time I'm looking after two orphans. The priority goes to them. When I get the money, I pay their school fee. And if there's any balance, I may get a plot of land for myself, for my future.
Hello, Dennis. I'm offended Desire calling. I've just been told that Isaac's situation, that there is no improvement. You're planning to take him also to the church. My sick brother, they told me they are going to take him out from the hospital and then they take him to church. I'm concerned. Because I'm even the one who has been paying fees for him. He had a mental problem. I left Uganda hoping that maybe there will be an improvement. But calling the sister, she has told me there is no improvement. So now she's suggesting to take him to the church of born agains and they pray for him.